Welcome you all to another episode of Thoughts and Education. Today we have with us Dr. Harish Krishnagaru, Director of Ashoka Women's Engineering College, Karnool. Dr. Harish Garu holds a PhD in Management Studies. He carries with him 16 years of experience working with the education and corporate sectors. It is this blend of experiences that include notable roles like the HR head at companies like Wipro and CSS Corp that has helped Dr. Harish Garu in successfully running Ashoka's Women's Engineering College for the last 8 years. He has been pivotal in achieving and maintaining 100% admission for the last 4 years. Sir, thanks a lot for your time, and your very consent in these troubling times shows your dedication towards the Institute. So thanks for your time again. Without further ado, let me get to the core of the interview by asking you to kindly speak about the key factors that kept you connected with the education system.
First of all, good morning. Thank you, Mr. Kiran, for giving this opportunity to share my ideas on your platform. Key factors which keeps me connected with the education institution. It all started, actually, I was never interested in education, to be honest. It was my wife who roped me into education. The initial bait was quality of life.
Right.
And more leisure time, basically. So I stepped into it, and now it's more than that, actually. It gives me satisfaction that we make a lot of difference in thousands of students, their future, in fact, the family connected with them.
Right.
So in corporate, you don't do that, you know. You are just productive, that's it. You don't make difference in lives. But here, I want to continue my journey with education because it is making a lot of difference in a lot of people's lives. And it gives a lot of satisfaction. So that is precisely the reason I want to continue my life in education and contribute more and more to the students' life and make difference in children's life. That's it.
Great, sir. I do agree that the making difference in our life is absent in the corporate world to a great extent.
Very much.
So at the outset, sir, comparing Indian education system now that we are actually growing leaps and bounds in changing the paradigm of education in India, how do you compare with the foreign structure of education, and how do you think the structure at Ashoka's Women's Engineering College helps these students?
Interesting question. I may not be able to comment much on the foreign education, but because I was educated and I am still educating in India, so I have my opinion on the education system of India. Education system is of two, there are two steps to it. One is the curriculum, the content of education, and the way it is delivered.
Right.
So the content of education in India is wonderful. It is one of the top notch, in fact, from the class one, I would say, from the grassroots level to the highest level, it is the best.
Right.
However, there is a major problem, if I may opinion it, because the education, the purpose of education is not really served in India.
Right.
If you interact with any of the children anywhere, you can just handpick them and ask them what is the purpose of education, they may not know.
Right.
The basic problem is students are always asked to chase their scores. But it's not the reality, actually. The scores are in between. It's just a byproduct. The idea is to give them knowledge, acquire that knowledge, and help them to retain the knowledge, and also help them or intrigue their minds to apply that knowledge in their lives.
Right.
That's what the basic idea is. But again, in India, it doesn't happen.
Right.
We cannot blame the students. It's from the faculty's point of view. We ask them to chase the scores. Students think that acquiring knowledge is the way to reach scores.
Yeah.
On the contrary, it is getting marks or scores is just a way to, it's a dipstick to check whether you've taken the knowledge enough or should you work more on it.
More on, yeah.
So students do not focus on acquiring knowledge. They instead chase the marks. And that very thing, this is a major problem. In fact, I have my son studying in school and I constantly worry about the matter. And I try to give him that, no, this is not the right way. Acquiring knowledge, understanding knowledge, using it in your life. And when you go in your higher education or technical education, use that for your professional life and success. It's not to forget.
No.
So that's the point. And in Ashoka, because I'm in top position, my thoughts can be involved. So this is the particular thing we address primarily. So in Ashoka, being a women's college, it really doesn't make a difference. But primarily, we teach our students to learn. We don't make them study. We make them to learn. We give them the idea of why they should study or why should they learn and what is the goal. So that mindset which they have carried from their primary education till their intermediate or 12th standard, we try to change it initially. And our faculties are also aware of the fact that what is the purpose of education.
True. Right.
After that, what we do is we make sure we teach them to learn. So learning, the problem with learning is they think learning is studying. You see the difference. Studying is reading.
Right.
Learning is acquiring knowledge.
Right.
So most of the students do not like to study because it involves reading.
Effort. Yeah. Yeah.
Bookish effort.
Yes.
So, but today it's not true. Okay. Learning can be done by reading. Learning can be done by seeing. Yep. Learning can be done by doing. Learning can be done by hearing.
Listen. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And thanks to the era we are living in, that audio visuals are always there.
Yes.
So we make sure our students learn not only by reading or the traditional bookish way. We incorporate a lot of audio visuals, animated thought process. Okay. So what happens? It is interesting. It also helps them to acquire knowledge quickly and retain them for a longer time.
True.
And the third process is to implement it. So we kindle their mind to implement their knowledge acquired in different areas.
Right.
So this is the basic purpose of learning. When they do this, they're successful. And our long-term goal is always employment, because we are a women's college. Okay. Right. So women empowerment ends up in financial independence.
True.
So we make sure they learn for the purpose of employment.
Right.
Okay. And they reach their goal. So this is what basically in Ashoka we do. The philosophy of learning, it's all about learning. The philosophy of learning is different in Ashoka. I hope so. Because other colleges, I respect other colleges also.
Yeah.
But in Ashoka, we particularly look at how they are learning and why they should learn. And when they learn, where they are reaching.
Got that. So I think that's a clarity that is rarely
found.
Yes, no, but that's very clear. It's very clear, sir.
Yeah,
and it's required at the top notch, at the top of the institution, because that decides the fate.
Very true.
Right. So one thing that also can be covered at this time is that what do you expect from the other side of the other side of the sphere, like from the student community? What do you think their responsibility is towards an institute? So you have the vision. Now, in implementing that and in maintaining that, what do you think the responsibility of the other side is?
Mr. Kiran, it's responsibility. As long as you are in education, responsibility always is on one side. It's always on the giving side. However, the responsibility is on the parents.
Right.
Because when we are telling them to do something or we are taking them in one direction,
right,
it is the responsibility of the parents also to take them in the same direction instead of opposite direction.
Right.
So students are always wet clay. They can be molded. They are not adults.
Right.
But when it comes to engineering college, where they are little grown up, so we motivate them.
Right.
The only thing which I require from the students is I would advise them to do is dream without boundaries. The only problem, see, the college I'm working in and the surrounding, it's in Kurnool. So yes. It's not a metro city. Okay. Yeah. So 80% of the students come around the Kurnool region and from other parts of Andhra Pradesh. Right. Very few students, 80%, 20% of students come from the big cities also.
Right.
So what I want them to do is not to have boundaries around them. They think small. They underestimate them. They think I cannot do.
Right.
So they don't dream big. They don't try big. They limit themselves. So that is the only problem they have. And I would request them, or that if you say what I want from them, right, is to dream big.
Right.
Because we are there to help you.
Right.
But dreaming big is quite important. So for example, there are very big companies, as a fresher, they are ready to give 25-30 lakhs package as a fresher.
Right.
But what happens, students think, because it's a big package, probably our knowledge is not good enough. Mm-hmm. So why should apply? Why should even try?
Right.
Why should even work behind it? But that's not true. There is a story that for competition for CEOs are much lesser than competition for level one employees.
Right. Yes.
So it's much easier.
Very true. Yeah.
So they just have to dream big and help us to achieve their dreams.
Got it, sir. Now, I think we have reached a very significant checkpoint in education because of the pandemic, and it has changed a lot of things. If not 10 years, what do you see the future of this Ashoka's Institute as well as education in Andhra Pradesh and Kurnool? What do you think are some trends that are going to evolve, or what's going to happen with education, higher education, according to you?
Okay. Obviously, because of this pandemic, the major change in pattern of education, everything has become online.
Yeah.
However, there was a challenge with the engineering college or engineering education to be online, is that, you know, if you observe, there are so many courses available in higher education which are on distance mode.
Right.
Only courses like engineering and medical, they are not available online or distance education.
Yeah,
because they need hands-on experience. Okay. But recent developments are also involving virtual labs.
Right.
Okay. So online, there are so many things available, so many things you can do.
Right.
And probably in next 10 years, possible that education, 80% of education will come online.
Right.
And the benefit of being online is you're not geographically restricted.
Right.
Hence the resources. For example, a resource which is critical, which is probably 1,000 miles away from you, because the resource cannot walk up to you, logistic issues are there, right, that is solved in a jiffy.
Right.
So the advantage of this is online is to get critical resources at your doorstep. So right, that is the major change which may happen in the next 10 years or probably happening right now.
Right.
Ashoka College, our vision when we started, the college started, it was the inception of the college was 12 years ago.
Okay.
However, there was a change in the management in 2014.
Okay.
That's when I came into picture. Our chairman, Sri Ashokavardhan Reddy, came into picture.
Right.
It is our vision which is changing the shaping Ashoka Women's Engineering College.
Right.
So we started. Basically, when we started off, everybody was saying that it's a women's college. Why do you want to invest there? You know, why don't you change it into co-education? Oh, right. It's more lucrative.
Right.
But again, our chairman, Ashokavardhan Reddy, he slept over the thought and he came next morning and told me, Harris will make this college number one women's engineering college in Andhra Pradesh. Because that's when Telangana and Andhra Pradesh got divided.
Right.
So there was number. So what happens? Narayanamma was the college actually he was referring to in Hyderabad.
Yes.
So he said, yeah. So now that the states have bifurcated, right. So we have number one college, women's college in Telangana. So right. Why not make our college number one women's engineering college in Andhra Pradesh?
Right.
And rightly said so. We have reached halfway in last 5 years. We are number one women's engineering college in Rayalaseema.
Excellent. Okay.
And precisely number two in Andhra Pradesh.
Right.
But our visions are evolving.
Right.
So because we are very close to our primary vision, we have moved our vision to become number one women's engineering college in southern part of India.
Right.
So next 10 years, definitely number one women's engineering college in the southern part of India, including 5 states.
I think you are implementing what you are preaching, sir, to dream big without boundaries. So that's...
Rightly said. Thanks for recognizing that.
Yeah, it is a noble thought. So with that, now that we are talking about the institute, two things that you would like the audience to know. One thing is about something that they would not know about the institute, and one biggest trend that you perceive in Ashoka's college.
Okay. Things which students may not know, the audience may not know about Ashoka College is primary, which I just said, the intention of the college
right.
towards the students. Okay. I don't think most of those colleges think only towards students.
Right.
Okay. So this college only thinks towards students, their prosperity, securing their future, giving them quality technical education, and make sure they understand that.
Right.
Okay. So that's primary thing. Apart from that, we are an affiliated college. So what happens, our curriculum is delivered or given to us by JNTU Anantapur, which is actually a top university,
yes.
which holds its rank in NIRF.
Right.
So it proves that it is a top curriculum. However, there are certain shortcomings.
Okay.
Generally, there are shortcomings. No curriculum is perfect. It doesn't complete the circle. So we have an initiative from our team. Okay, the team is made of a few people like me,
right.
few more inbound inside college, few senior faculties, and a few associates from the industry, big industries,
right.
A few CEOs of the companies. They are our consultants, and the purpose of this team was to develop a curriculum which addresses the shortcomings of the traditional curriculum.
Right. Okay.
So, and if I may reveal, the curriculum which we have developed is called Brain Box.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. We have registered the Brain Box, and very soon it will be out. The Brain Box, what it does is, It particularly, as I said, it only addresses the shortcomings of the curriculum.
Right. Okay.
Of traditional curriculum. Mm-hmm. So, for example, no curriculum involves soft skill training.
Right.
No curriculum, in fact, addresses the personality enhancement. No, many of the university curriculums do not address latest trends in the industry.
Right.
That's most important. Okay. So they study the basics and little outdated trends. But the industry is evolving very fast. So for our students to get a place in next 4 years, they should be clued up with what's exactly happening in the industry.
True.
And the technology has to be delivered to them.
Right.
They should be pre-trained. They should not, like, for example, AI is trending now. So AI is now it's in the curriculum also.
Yeah.
However, we implemented AI 3 years ago.
Okay.
So our students are learning all the softwares associated with AI.
Right.
Most of the projects, mini projects, internships were delivered to the students and pushed by the students to be on the AI platform.
Right.
So keeping them ahead is what BrainBox does.
Okay.
It makes sure they are complete product. BrainBox makes sure that their journey from campus to corporate is exciting, adventurous,
right.
and complete.
Okay.
So that's most important.
Right.
So that is what basically I would say from our side, from Ashoka, we do extra. Like, this is what we complete the circle, which is left by the curriculum, traditional curriculum.
Right. I do know colleges who pretty much say that my curriculum is bounded because of my affiliation, but I think this is the kind of thought that we need to foster in and around.
The only challenge you come across is that the curriculum is given to you from the university,
yeah,
and the timeline is also given.
Given, yes.
So what happens? The only constraint is time. If you want to teach your students apart from curriculum something,
right.
it demands more time.
Right.
And we the only advantage we have is We have a huge on-campus, we are a residential college, and we have a huge on-campus hostel, women's hostel, with 1,200 women occupants, students.
Okay.
So 80% of students are from hostel.
Right.
Hence, we are able to get more time, we are able to buy more time from students and deliver the necessary shortcoming things from the curriculum to the students and make them complete. That's our advantage, in fact.
Got that, sir. Excellent. Thank you. Current challenges do you see for higher education? I think Kurnool city, you might be aware of a few challenges with the city itself, but with higher education and for Ashoka's Institute and with the geography of it, what challenges do you see, and how do you plan to take them on?
If at all I have to talk about Ashoka College's challenges, right, I would talk only about that. Right. We are a women's engineering college.
Right.
So our purpose is to empower our students, women students. Yeah, that's the ultimate goal. The challenges what we come across is that mindset. Okay, when we talk about women empowerment, okay, that's generally happens through knowledge acquiring of knowledge and financial independence.
Right.
So here what happens is parents who are not a little conservative, generally they were conservative, they have come forward to make them study engineering.
Right.
But when it comes to placements, we give them placement, top-notch placements. Students are quite smart in grasping and getting opportunities. In fact, many of the students got opportunities abroad.
Okay.
However, the parents are reluctant to put them to the companies or send them away from them.
Right.
The primary difficulty is that parents are a little conservative. They don't want to break the boundaries. We are in Kurnool, so the placements in Chennai, Hyderabad, Bangalore are quite successful.
Right.
But when we push our boundaries a little further, like Pune, Bombay or any other city,
right,
parents are not very interested, where the students are interested.
Right.
So with time, I think this with the time, these challenges will be also taken care.
Right.
That's the only challenge we have. Apart from that, everything is good. We don't think big challenges are there, and every day is a challenge. In fact, when you talk about challenge, every day is a challenge. Every day we have to achieve new things.
Right.
Changing people's mind is most important. I can call it a problem, I can call it a challenge, I can call it, that's the goal. So it's collective, it is collective, it is not individual.
Right. I'm sure we can go on and on about the Institute because you think about it daily, but I would like to bring it to a conclusion. But before we conclude, I would like to know a message that you would want to give to the current youth aspirants from, because you have seen the other side of things as well, right? So for people who are waiting for their chance at the corporate world or entering a college, what message would you want to give to them?
Message would be simple. As I already said, dream big. And dream limitless. Do not put limitations to yourself. Do not put boundaries to yourself. Do not think because you are from a small school or not a very big, the students think that way, that I'm not from a, forget about schools. Many students who think like I'm from tier two city, like Kurnool, I may not be able to compete with the global audience. So these hindrances, these inhibitions, you should get rid of, because believe me, it doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter. If that was true, I will not be in Kurnool. I was born in Calcutta and I was raised in a metro city, but I will not be in Kurnool and raise my child in Kurnool.
Right.
Because the city doesn't matter. The school doesn't matter.
Right.
The way you think matters. So the world is your playground. Okay. You can venture anywhere. There will be certain challenges. You overcome the challenges. Only thing is you have to focus on yourself.
Right.
Go forward. do not limit yourself. That is the only thing I would say. And for all the women out there, it's especially for them, do not limit yourself. Because the government, the society, education institutions, your parents, everybody wants you to be successful. So why not? Why don't you think you should be successful? And when you go for the journey of success, a lot of hindrances, a lot of challenges, a lot of problems come. But the idea is to fight the challenges and go forward. So I want, this is the message from my side, do not limit yourself. From Ashoka Women's Engineering College, that is the only message I want to give to all the students, particularly women students.
God, that's a brilliant. Thanks a lot for your time again. My pleasure interacting with you, and I can see the energy that you would bring at your institute just in this small snippet of time. So I hope you achieve your goal of becoming the biggest women institute in the south of India pretty soon, sooner than you think. And with that, sir, I would like to thank you for your time again.
I thank College Duniya for giving me this opportunity to share my thoughts on education, and particularly engineering education, and precisely for women education. So this is kind of an empowerment you give us, okay? Because not very seldom you come across these opportunities. Because these thoughts which are there in our minds, we can only implement in our college, but not to the society. So the platform like College Duniya helps us to reach out to the bigger crowd, bigger audience. And I thank you very much for giving this opportunity, and particularly Mr. Kiran for being the host and the interviewer. And hope to see many more things coming in the front.
True, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Our pleasure. Thank you.
It was a great pleasure. Thank you very much.